tell me about you, about the bikes and about him.
Right, well, we kind of met because of bikes. Our friend did up bikes. We all got together and used to go out together and everything, and then we got together.
You two got it together.
Yeah, and I know he was a good sound engineer, but bikes was his thing, actually.
That was his thing,
yeah.
Was it?
Yeah, and particularly aerials.
Tell me about the collection here and how we can help.
Well, if you look around, I'm having an extension, and, you know, extensions are you really need
expensive.
A bit of a contingency fund and everything, and I haven't got enough for a kitchen. That's
okay.
Basically how you could
That's
help.
That's why we're here.
So, okay, so two wheels into a kitchen.
Yeah.
Okay, well, just looking in here, there's plenty to look at.
Yep. So, Mandy, look, Fuzz and I will have a little whiz around, all right, and then hopefully at the end of the day, we might have a haggle.
Come on in, let's get in there. Ooh, now look. There are loads of bikes hidden away in here. Fantastic.
Should we just start here?
Yeah.
We have a Vincent. It looks like a Rapide.
Yeah.
It's not a Black Shadow, which is the posher version.
What do you mean?
Because there's not the 150 Speedo, the big one.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, you know, it's going to be quick enough though, isn't it?
What, without the Speedo?
Yeah.
Used to be called the Plumber's Nightmare. The early ones.
What is that?
Because of all the exposed oil lines and all that kind of stuff.
Oh, that's great. That's just like a gardener engine. I've told you about those in the past.
God,
but no, I like stuff like that. I think that's
Sorry,
great.
Mate. I've just got to disturb you because Mandy's bringing the tea in. Yeah. Come on in,
Fantastic.
Mandy.
Fantastic.
Here we go, fellas.
Thank you.
Oh, darling, is that my
one?
Yeah.
Mandy, this is a great place to start, isn't it? Right here, right now.
This is a great looking bike.
Yeah, and honestly, riding these things, honestly, Fuzzy, they are amazing. You know, just the most beautiful thing, just so way ahead of their time.
Well, all my husband wanted to do was ride one.
The Vincent's a beauty, but it's probably beyond our budget. A cheaper option could be an aerial from Ian's collection.
But look, we've got there just straight away one of my favourite motorcycles, Ariel Square 4. Do you know much about that one? Did that come back from Australia?
No, nothing actually came back from Australia.
Oh, okay.
We
just
sold
you.
Just me.
That's lovely, I love those things. But they would say in a sales catalogue, it needs light recommissioning.
Yes.
Doesn't it? Rather like me.
Well,
it could be heavy recommissioning. It could be a total rebuild.
Yeah, what do you reckon?
Well, I don't know.
Hey, Mandy, look, we're going to wander around with the tea. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Great stuff.
The Ariel Square 4 is a start, but round the corner, there's plenty more aerials.
Go on.
Go on, then.
Like this pair of lovely Huntmasters.
I can't get it off.
Oh, I tell you, there you go. I think that looks like a sister bike to this one. So we've got here an aerial Huntmaster and a friend.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, okay, that's nice enough bikes.
Now, were they, they're 650 twins, weren't they? They were kind of sort of the bank manager's 50s commuter.
That's right. I suppose, you know, in the summer days, why take out the Ford Consul? When you could get on the bike and get there a bit quicker.
So look, we've got a row there of pre-war aerials.
Clearly, they've been dragged out of where they've been sitting for a very long time, and now they're sitting here waiting to be restored.
Now look, right, but I think we know a man who knows all about this.
Yeah, does his name begin with S?
So there's this one, which Mandy's very sweetly labelled up.
1932 Cami 600.
Yeah, so that's overhead camshaft square four, second year, second model. Has it got British papers?
It looks like it. It's on British plates anyway.
What do you reckon, Sammy, if they're basically barn finds? I mean, have you got any vibe on a price?
Oh, it's difficult to tell without dragging them out from under the shelf.
Yeah, it would help, wouldn't it?
It's super rare, but the parts are nearly unobtainable.
Okay.
So it's sort of down to how complete they are, really. I'd love to own them all.
Oh, OK, all right. Well, look, let's just leave it like that. Me and Fuzzy will see you real soon. All right, mate.
The three of us, we could have one each.
Yeah, we could.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Yeah, so it'd be a square three. There you go. OK, bye, mate. The Vincent, how much would that be?
Well, I'd like to get about 30 grand for it.
OK. Now, if I was in the market, I would say that's quite a fair price,
Yeah, absolutely so.
Yeah. Now, look, moving along.
Yeah, we've got two Huntmasters, actually.
Two Huntmasters.
Yeah,
and they're
the
good.
Maroon.
My husband used to ride them just up to Rufforth to the swap meets and whatnot.
Right.
But they're not bringing that much at the moment. I know they're not. As close as possible to 5 grand I could get, I'd like.
Now, in the little room there, there's a Red Hunter.
Yes.
How much is that?
5 grand.
Four?
Can I come up a little bit?
3.5?
Yeah, okay. I can take that. Okay.
Thanks, Mandy. Yep. I think that's great, don't you?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's cool.
All right, I think that's a fair price. You're happy with that?
Yeah.
Great, Mandy.
Yeah, that's fine.
If you're happy, we're happy.
First, we connect up the battery. Then I tickle some extra fuel into the carb.
So we're basically giving the carb a head start.
Oh, yeah,
there we go. That's it. There you go.
Then I give the kickstart a kick.
God, that sounds awful.
And another one. And another one, but the engine won't start.
You try it.
So Guy takes over and...
Oh, my God. That's all right, stop a minute.
Time to call in the cavalry. Workshop assistant, Ed.
We've got some muscle now to kick it because we think it might be, well, due to his little spindly sparrow's kneecaps. Hmm?
I am 60.
I know you're 60, and you've got funny little legs and sensitive feet.
And
Ed, on the other hand, hasn't got... Look at the muscle there! Look at it! Look at the size of the boot! Hey.
Do you realise this motorcycle and me have 125 years between us?
Just sit down, OK, take the weight off. Ed's going to come in and sort us out. The youth will prevail.
Amazing! Finally, it's running. Ed's boot did the trick, even if he also caused the battery to fall out.
It's running nicely without. Don't worry about it. Right.
So without more ado, I mount up.
Right. Right, we're off. It works, it works.
Starting was harder than we thought, but look at it now. According to Motorcycle Magazine of 1957, the Huntmaster combined performance with rideability. 66 years later, you can't say better than that.
Well, we've snatched victory out of the jaws of defeat.
Yes.
Hey?
Yeah, lovely.
Roll on tomorrow.
Next morning, Guy solders the cable to the torn battery terminal.
Soldering is a needs must for me. I have to do the odd thing. I try to avoid it.
And this time, he makes sure to lock in the battery with a cable tie.
Have you actually done some soldering?
Yes.
In that hat?
In this hat, which was a present from Alan Milliard this morning, knitted by his fair wife, Tracy, and I'm over the moon with it, so don't you say anything.
Sorry, mate, I just think it's rather like a large strawberry on your head.
Guy won't rise to the bait, so I let him get on with it.
Have you done it yet?
It's in good nick already, but the application of a little polish, supplemented by a lot of elbow grease, brings the chrome up a treat.
When you're putting this stuff on, the metal polish, on aluminium especially, work in small circles, and don't cover the whole bike. Work on an area, so a timing cover, circular motion, work it in there. When it goes black and horrible, wipe it off with your clean rag, have a look, and if you need to, go again.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
Yeah, good, good.
Now, Sammy, have I got a treat for you? You kind of know the treat because I've sent you photos. Did you like what you saw in your armchair in your workshop?
Very much so. It was in the right shade of maroon.
Hey! Now, look, I'm hoping in one way that you don't want this, right? Only because I can only charge $4,000.
I am only going to give you 3.5.
Can I have 250 quid profit? 3750, let's call it quits.
Yeah, go on then.
Oh, happy days.
Well, it's sort of happy days. It's sort of, you know, keeping it in the family, mates rates type tip, isn't it, really?
And you are going to deliver it for that, right?
Oh. What are you up to next Tuesday, Skid?
I'll ride it down there.
All right, he's going to ride it down there.
All right, no problem. Pasties provided.
Hey, look, love you lots. See you soon. All right, Fuzz sends his love. All right.
Thanks for the bike.
Okay, mate.
See you, mate.
All right. Bye. Bye.